think that because they've gone through so much, everything is emotional with them. It's been sensational. Can they go and lift themselves again against a side like France or England, who have the capabilities of actually breaking you down? That's the point. So I don't think anyone's perception of Morocco. When you come into the tournament, did I think that Morocco were going to play in the semi-final? Not at all. Did anybody of us? Not really. Have we got so much heart, or sorry, so much respect for them? Absolutely. Will they come and battle again? Absolutely. But do I think that France and England would think the winners of that game have a really great chance of progressing to the final? That's my view. That's how I totally agree.
Exactly what he said is perfect. You know, sometimes people think that it's better to lose against a top team when you go home. Me? Give me the smallest one. Give me the weakest one. I'm going to have a better chance to win, with any doubt. Now, the big thing about Morocco now, they know what they're going to do. So the teams, they're going to prepare in a different way. Maybe in the beginning of the tournament, it was different. You know, in the groups, you need points, and you get a point here and where. Now, they beat Spain and they beat Portugal without conceding. So the idea of the teams playing, England or France, they're going to be prepared to go from the, you know, from the beginning. They're going to go at them. And then if you score first, then Morocco needs to change. They cannot keep defending only, and that will be a different game. With the rest, you have a chance. You know, you play Portugal, it's an open game. You attack, I attack. It's a different game. They create the game for themselves. So you need to try to break that plan that so far is working very well.
Well, whichever it may be, England or France, whether it's, of course, Euro finalists or reigning champions, it's going to be a much different challenge to Morocco. Let's talk about Cristiano very, very quickly then. What's next for him? We saw him emotional. He's 37. The next time the World Cup comes around, he's going to be 41. Have we seen the last of Cristiano at a major tournament?
For me, yes. Yes, I think Cristiano is upset today. Sorry, he's upset today because he believes so much in him to get to the semifinals.
Yeah.
And you are Cristiano Ronaldo, you think it's your last World Cup, and you want to play those semifinals and maybe be in the final and having a chance of winning it. And now everything went away in 90 minutes, which is hard to take.
Well, I think the pictures probably tell the story there. I think he feels that at 41 years of age, the World Cup is beyond him. I think that. He's really won the Euros anyway, even though he might not have participated for too long in the final against France, I think it was in 2016. But I think it was the World Cup. It was that thought that was probably keeping him going. And he may well have felt that if they could beat Morocco, suddenly they're in the semi-final and they feel as if they've got a chance. And he might have patched up everything with Santos. Santos brings him on. We mentioned this at halftime. I knew it wouldn't be too long before you bring him on because he still can win a match for you. But overall, I think, Michel, I honestly think that I agree with Gus. I think the next World Cup is a step beyond.
The next Euro, perhaps?
Euro, but that'll have, that, yes, I'm sure he will strive for that. I'm sure he'll probably think about it. But will that have the same impact? No, he's won that.
He's won that.
So I think he'll push that to the side.
So we've always had the debate, is it Messi or Cristiano Ronaldo? If, because Argentina has progressed, if Lionel Messi wins the World Cup, does that clear the debate that it's Lionel Messi above all?
I think Messi's phenomenal player. Listen, I wouldn't mind as a manager if someone said you only can have one of the two of them. I wouldn't mind, which that doesn't really matter. But essentially, I think that Messi sees a bigger picture than anyone. I think he can. The number of assists he has as well, too. Never mind the goals that he scored, puts him in a position. I think that Messi's the best I've seen, certainly in the last 25 years.
Yes.
It will help the doubters. It will help the people that think that, for example, the Argentinians, they were always saying, okay, Maradona is better because he won the World Cup. And Messi, and he couldn't win anything. And then he won the Copa America. And now they're thinking, okay, maybe now they're going to put it next to Maradona. Next to Maradona, yes. I think that the other matter is a matter of what you prefer. Messi's is unique.
Over Cristiano Ronaldo, you pick Messi over Cristiano?
No, I pick Messi. I really like Cristiano Ronaldo. His best, when he was playing for Manchester Real Madrid, it was kind of a joke, that goal of Cristiano Ronaldo.
Yes, of course.
And then a goal, and you go, Cristiano Ronaldo. Absolutely. It's like it's not fair. Yeah, that's the truth. So it was incredible.
Absolutely.
The problem is that Messi is natural.
Yeah.
Messi, what Messi did yesterday with the pass is not Cristiano Ronaldo.
Yeah.
Cristiano Ronaldo will never do that. That pass, that weight on the pass, through the legs, without looking, only Messi knew that his teammate was running. That's not Cristiano Ronaldo. So it's a different game. One was a machine of scoring goals, Cristiano Ronaldo. The other one is, would you say yesterday, Inter?
Intergalactic. They're absolutely. So yeah, the two of them are so far superior to anything else that has been around for the last 20-odd years.
Yeah, I think everyone can agree with that statement, for sure. But thanks, Martin, and thanks, guys, for being here for this game. You gents will be staying on. Glenn Johnson will be joining us for the next one. Mm-hmm. Big one, England versus France.
Wow.
Oof, arguably the biggest quarterfinal fixture that we have in this round of fixtures.